It's not often I buy a new camera. If anything, I've been telling people that since 2010, cameras have been more than enough, especially if you're shooting in the daytime. That being said, recently I purchased the Kolari Pocket infrared camera. Now this camera is from 2016. For all those people who care about megapixels, it is 20 megapixels. Considering the fact that infrared is something you take during the day, I don't really think it matters so much about the sensor size or when the camera came out, because every camera these days is frankly more than enough. Now, the reason I picked up the Pocket, despite already owning a 35 millimeter full spectrum converted infrared camera, is quite frankly, I do a lot of traveling and it's a huge burden carrying so much gear with me. I really want to travel light this time, especially since I'll be out in the countryside climbing mountains, and I really want something that fits in my pocket and I can take out anytime without any stress. Now, the reason I'm talking about this camera is because you're getting a taste of infrared for only 300 bucks, and that's pretty good. Now, I've been using Kolari for many years. Now, I'm not getting sponsored for this video or anything. I'm not getting any kickbacks. I don't have any affiliate links. I pay for everything myself, but I've been using Kolari Vision and LifePixel, both companies, since around 2014, 2015. I've been taking infrared photos for a long time. I've never had any issues with any of them. And I've been using this camera for a while now. Unlike most other YouTubers who get these cameras and they make a review not even knowing what they're talking about half the time. But I'm going on a tangent here. Here are some of the pictures I was able to get out of this camera. Now, infrared is best taken in a midday sun in the middle of summer, which is contrary to what every other photographer tells you to do. You're not supposed to photograph in the middle of the day because of the harsh shadows. But with infrared, you can. If anything, it's encouraged. Now, it's winter in Korea, so I don't have the best light per se. But I was able to get some pretty decent looking photos. Now, there is an option to include a CHDK enabled card. For those of you who may know about Canon, there is a program called Magic Lantern, which I've been using for a long time in my 5D Mark IIIs, IIs, Ms. It basically unlocks more functionality out of your camera that Canon cameras are more than capable of doing, but Canon likes to paywall you with different models. Now, you are able to upload this program basically for free online, but Kolari does offer you this option if you're willing to pay for it. It comes with the card and the program already pre-installed, but if you're tech savvy enough, say like me, you're able to just install it onto any card for free. But if you don't want to deal with any of that, you can just pay Kolari to do it. It's not that much of a difference. Now, the reason I bring this up is because it unlocks the raw functionality that the PowerShot doesn't have. However, I've been shooting raw and JPEG for a bit now, and I'm a bit stumped with this camera because whenever I get the DNG RAW files, I can't change the white balance as much as I wish. Now, in the past, I was able to create my own DNG profile for infrared cameras in Adobe Lightroom, but something's changed over the past few years. I'm not able to do that anymore. It's incredibly frustrating for my editing flow. So, pictures just come out looking ultraviolet. However, my JPEGs come out exactly like I want them to. Now, I do have tutorials on how to edit these photos in this manner, but you're able to see I can get some real nice shots out of the power shots. Perfect for my upcoming Japan trip, where I will be walking quite a bit, climbing up and down the mountains, and it'll be perfect to have this little camera in my pocket with me the entire time. I do have to say, one thing I don't like about the PowerShot is how small the battery is. However, It is cheap enough and portable enough that I can buy more than one if I need to. However, I don't think that will probably be the case. This is a full spectrum converted camera. It also comes with the option of getting multiple infrared filters with it. I got the 720 nanometer filter. I also got the hot mirror and the 590 nanometer. So the pink trees and stuff is the ones you get with the 590 nanometer. 720 nanometers gives you more of that black and white look. And the hot mirror filter allows you to take normal pictures with the camera should you ever need to. Do I recommend this camera? Absolutely. From a seasoned full spectrum infrared photographer, I very much like the Kolari Pocket. Now, it's not gonna replace my already full sensored camera, which quite frankly is amazing, but I am slowly getting older and I'm getting tired of carrying so much when I travel. So having this with me pretty much all the time, especially up and down a mountain, fantastic. So yes, those are my thoughts on the Kolari Pockets. I hope somebody out there finds this useful. Catch you around.